I've dreamed of being a very successful filmmaker, with my movies being seen all over the world. And you know what? I found out, like I knew, it would take a lot of hard work. But I knew that eventually something good would happen from all my work. And now, my new movie, The Party. What are you doing?
Making some barbecue pineapple sliders.
Really?
Yes.
And you got some meat going on there.
Mm-hmm. Flank steak.
What's your role at this party?
Friend and cuisinist. Just kidding. Don't! I'm shy. Moving around all frantic.
How many guests are you expecting?
You know, I'm not 100% sure. You're going to have to ask Em about that.
This is one of those cool Hollywood parties you hear about.
Yes, it is.
Whoa, the good life, full of fun, seems to be the ideal. Yes, the good life lets you hide all the sadness you feel.
Can you drink that whole bottle?
Sure.
Go ahead.
Feed the people, Dennis. Feed the people.
Give them dignity.
And they will not feed upon thee. That's scripture. According to Jealous, Jewish Jealous. No, I mean, when you read about the fact that they quarantine these people. There's an embargo, they control every imports and exports. They cut down the Gaza's ability to export whatever they manufacture there. So they create an unemployed sub-society that is destined to just die or shrivel up and accept their defeat.
It's killing them off. And just want them to take on, and then they got their land.
They wanted to drill into them that they are a defeated people. That's what one of them.
I understand. Okay, because I gotta go.
And out of the seeds of that misery, you're going to harvest. What are you going to harvest from the seeds of that misery? You know, it's just something that's going to perpetuate itself.
A new fashion statement.
It is a fashion statement, Alex.
Okay,
hold that.
Be very careful.
Yeah, I mean, it's just so...
It's sadness. It's just... It's real sad.
I already talked it over.
It's blatantly, and Bush, they just did this thing now.
Right under the wire.
Under the wire.
That is it.
Unbelievable.
It's so transparent.
It is so transparent.
I'm going right now to
Jehovah's,
and I'll meet you guys over there in like half an hour.
Jehovah's, feed the answer.
The people.
What is the answer, Jehovah's?
Jehovah's says the people.
What should Israel do, Jehovah's?
In like 30 minutes.
They got a lot of fucking money and a lot of smarts. Yeah. Go down there and retool that place and make it livable.
Exactly.
Employ these people.
Oh,
give them opportunity.
Jonas has spoken.
It's sort of like South Central. It's like the one opportunity is to sell crack or make a hit rap album.
Right.
And they don't even have crack and they're not recording rap. So what do you expect? And then they're cutting off like the supply line to Egypt. They're not getting food, medical.
And they're trapped.
They're trapped.
Normally refugees in a war situation, what
worse
do they do?
Worse than a ghetto. It's a trap.
They try to get out. They try to get out and they go to the next neighboring country. They can't get out. They're trapped like rats.
Yeah.
It's not great. It's not great.
It's not a simple solution, but the only solution is, you know, up with people.
I just hired all these girls to work for my production company, and I'm going to be paying you girls a lot of money.
How much?
And benefits. Is that, are you all right?
How much
with
is
that?
A lot?
A lot.
It's relative, so how much?
Like 50% of whatever I make.
That's not going to be a lot,
it's
is
be
it?
A lot.
We don't go that way. We take a fixed rate.
On the if comes. Is that all right?
No, Vix Ray, we're talking about
how much do you want? Just tell me, what's reasonable?
I don't know.
I'm all about whatever's fair.
100 G's a year, is that enough?
Plus expenses?
Anna will take that job.
Anna will take it.
I'll take
she
it.
Likes to do part-time.
Admittedly, every couple of months.
Yeah, that's
it. You know, but girls, I have to warn you, I am a swinging bachelor. So kind of ignore that. You know what I mean?
We will, don't worry.
Okay.
Have you had any
You've been on camera many times. You've directed movies.
Well, you know.
What's your claim to fame? How many movies have you made?
I have no fame to claim.
But you made movies.
I've just made a movie.
What's the name of it?
We call it America So Beautiful.
Really?
Remember that? Remember when you were...
I was trying to get in.
You were going to be one of the bouncers.
I was flagging you down, hoping to be in your movie. It never happened.
Sorry.
That's okay.
We'll do another one.
Okay. Are you still screening your films at the Archlight?
No, that's like a long time ago.
We'll do the exchange.
Long time ago. It's already been, can you imagine how fast time flies? It's already been almost six years ago.
Yeah, Dennis Woodruff is still alive and well.
You're looking alive and well, yeah. I like your hat. Is that from New Year's Eve or what?
No, this is Willard's hat. I stole it.
Oh, yeah.
I traded hats upstairs when I was going through his belongings.
Are you a wide angle here?
I got his checkbook and his credit cards, but he doesn't know it yet.
You should steal some of his Banana Republic t-shirts. He's got a lot of those.
More people arriving.
Check me out.
Explain what you were doing tonight.
I know.
Here, just to say, I love
Willard,
you.
I was upstairs and I got a hold of your gold American Express card and some of your other credit cards. I hope you don't mind. I'll bring them back in a couple of days. Oh, no,
that's okay. Just go to Costco and get some of that.
I'll go to Kmart
cheese.
Because I like you.
You live in Boston?
Only
no,
Kmart.
I just got up.
God, you believe this is like January 12th? It's just like summer.
It's just really heavy.
The cups,
cup glasses.
That's cute.
I'd like to issue a ticket.
Cough
spread them. Take your clothes off.
1980 cough glasses like chips.
Could you imagine?
I want to get the Wayfarers.
That'd be like Armin's girlfriend.
Oh my god.
Spread them. I'm not kidding. She wants to be a cop.
Oh yeah.
Armin's girlfriend.
Oh, that one? Oh, yeah. Ned?
She's half Mexican, half Lebanese.
That's
huge. She's huge.
She's huge, like
but
in
it's
the chest
area? Or yeah, in the chest. Oh. They're like watermelons. Yeah. And then
are they
she
bigger
even,
than Liza's?
Yeah, she's
whatever.
And she wears like padded bras on top
no
of
no way!
Oh
yeah.
Why?
So she looks
wrong.
Even bigger.
She's
like a cup size bigger.
That's just wrong.
She's
and
a
she's
D cup.
Front time. She's not so skinny.
No, she's a D cup too. She can't be a C.
She's
a D. She's
a
D, right?
For sure.
But she's like. Yeah.
Tall and short.
She's short, little.
Yeah, she's really tiny. You've seen her.
You've seen her a lot of times.
Yeah, I can't. How could you forget the booth?
I don't know. Maybe she was just not interesting.
No, they're like huge.
Why do women have boob jobs?
I wouldn't know because they don't have one, obviously.
The same question as
what a question. Like
know.
He doesn't know the answer.
No. I like natural beauty. I don't want boob jobs.
Uh-huh.
Of course, I don't want to offend anyone here if you had one. If you spent all that money.
Oh, yeah.
I think we're all good. We're like,
we're all good
out here. We're all natural.
So I'm safe.
Yes.
And unpadded.
Completely unpadded.
You know what they say about men? It's not the size, it's what you do with it. Does that mean anything?
No.
Not so much.
We disagree.
Is bigger better? My God. Wait till you see what I got, baby.
What a rowdy crowd, I'll tell you.
I make the word huge look small. Excuse me, sir, why are you taking pictures?
This is a digital camera.
And are you capturing the moment? Are you a film? Are you an artist? You are an artist, aren't you?
I'm just addicted to my digital camera for no particularly good reason. It's probably a fear of death.
How many pictures have you actually taken with that over the
I have no idea. Probably as many as I'm afraid to die with.
Like hundreds, thousands?
I don't know. I can't tell. It's not a good question. After I said I took them because I was afraid to die, you should have thought of something else to ask me as opposed to that sort of quantitative thing. You should have thought of, like, you know, why I digress. But I don't digress. They're synchronistic, sympathetic segues. So you have to follow with your synchronistic segue.
Is it true what they say, that the mind is an infinite highway to the subconscious?
That sounds
very Freudian.
That sounds kind of like, listen, if Americans. I only want you to take a close-up. If ignorance is bliss, then why do Americans need Prozac?
Well, look up here a bit. The audience is over here.
What are our main schedules? Art, library, it's sports class. What else? We do, like, on Tuesdays activities that we both do, ballet together. Really
fun stuff. How are you?
Hello.
How are you?
Oh, hi. I'm Dennis Woodruff.
Dennis Woodruff. Welcome. Yes. Bye-bye.
Welcome to Willard Morgan's party.
Thank you very much. Nice to be here.
Yeah.
Hello.
Wow.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, so you're having a good 2009? Looks like you should.
Actually, thank you so much for getting
on. You just met someone?
Yeah.
You met that guy?
I think I know him.
Really?
I heard you got divorced, young man.
And I just want to talk to him.
Oh, you want to talk to him?
Yeah.
But I'm just talking to you now. I'm just wondering how your year's going.
Just now,
right, it's a whole new year ahead of us.
us.
Yeah, well, everybody, you know. Okay. The world, America, Los Angeles. This is Los Angeles, isn't it? Where are you from, by the way?
Melbourne.
Melbourne?
Yes.
Wow.
I'm usually quite uncomfortable at parties, but at this one I feel right at home.
Trying to get you and the host.
What?
You and the host at the most.
Willard Morgan, I think. Yeah.
And how do you know Willard?
Howdy. Yowza. I think I met Willard about 10, 15 years ago, and he asked me to be in this film. He said, I'm a art nouveau filmmaker, and I want you to be in my film. And I said, oh, okay. And he took more pictures of the car than he did of me. Really hurt my feelings. But now that I know Willard, he's bi-coastal. He lives in New York, and he comes over occasionally, but the rest of the year he's traveling all over the world. And occasionally I get a call from him. He's in Tokyo or Palm Beach or very, 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 you know, shishi crowd, you know. Hi.
Hi.
I'm Dennis Woodruff.
I'm Josh. Very nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Oh, I've seen you on TV before or something.
Are you enjoying the party?
Absolutely. This is the prime example of Willard's great ability to be completely hospitable and welcoming to people he loves
into
knows.
The societies of the rich and famous, and even the poor and unknown. A lot of people don't know that Willard has given millions and millions of dollars to charitable organizations.
As we all should.
He keeps a small amount for himself.
Just 1 million.
The oldest woman in the room.
Okay. How much money have you given to charity this year?
I've given.
Millions.
Sure.
Millions. Not quite. Well, let's talk percentages here.
Percentages.
We'll talk percentages and then...
Well, how much should someone give to charity?
Well, if we're talking about your disposable income, right, after everything else has been said and done, at least some.
How much?
Well, you know, hey, if you do 10%, at least you're giving to charity. If you do half, then that's a beautiful thing.
Well, my idea is to balance the economy as if all the rich people would get half their money to the poor, then everybody would be equal, right?
I'm in, man. Can I get in the poor line?
Yeah, me too.
I kissed her and she kissed me. Like the fella once said, ain't that a kick in the head? The room was completely black. I hugged her and she hugged back. Like the sailor said, folk, ain't that a hole in a boat?
You're going to be seeing a lot of butt crack, believe me, and just ignore it.
Do you pick up your dates in that car?
No, I have a new sports car.
I know, but before.
No, only skanky hoes. And I don't go over that. If I can't have A, class A, I don't want it.
The junkyard?
Junkyard dogs, baby. If I can't have class A shit, I don't want anything at all. That's the way I am. If I can't have girls like you, I don't even want to date. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
I might as well check into a restaurant.
There's a lot of action in those rest homes.
Oh, really?
Well, because the men are lacking, you know? The women get all crazy. All the men are dead.
They hand out dildos for Christmas. That's what they all get for
Christmas.
And my grandmother got one that had like lights that flash on and off.
It was
at night.
Chromotherapy.
Yeah.
Chromotherapy dildos.
She's all interested. The freaky stars she's into.
My grandmother got the one that glows in the dark. It glows in the dark. So if she loses it, she can find it. Are you ducking out of the party?
Yeah, dude, I gotta go right now because I gotta feed my donkey.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay. I'll see you, dude.
Okay, later.
You rock.
Peace.
Okay.
Rock out!
I'll see you, Keith.
Okay, dude.
Call me.
I will.
We'll do lunch.
So I was at this party last week, and my mother started making out with a gardener.
And what did you do?
It was kind of awkward.
Go ahead. And then what happened?
You're gonna say.
Oh, I'm listening. No, you have to say it.
No, you gotta say it. And then what happened?
And then what happened?
She started tongue kissing him in front of all the grass.
Oh, that's kind of bad.
I don't know. If you were the gardener, it was pretty good. My mom's a good kisser, so I've heard.
Sounds terrible.
Well, it depends on what you want in a party. Pretty good for my mom. Not so good for my dad.
Is your mom hot?
She's over there!
Where is she?
She's over there!
Is this your mom?
No.
Oh, where's... Oh, hi!
Hi! I'm Rob's mom!
I'm his grandma.
Yep. What's your name?
Mary.
Oh, hi, Mary. Nice to meet you. I'm Dennis Woodrow.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure.
Thank you.
And hi, Dennis. Nice. I'm Bill.
Hi, Bill.
I'm Rob's father.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Where's Rob?
Rob is the one that you talked to.
All I had was Rob.
Are you Rob?
I'm Rob.
Yeah. We also need to...
Is that the size of your penis?
That's the end of what is left. It's been a hard party.
A lot of you don't know it, that when I was a kid, I was a midget. And I had a big penis, though. That was the only thing that was normal.
So you're normal now?
I'm normal now.
Really?
My body.
The penis didn't grow. The penis stayed the same.
And my love life never improved either.
Well, with those cars, it can't.
No. You think that put a damper on my love life?
Absolutely. Yes.
Absolutely.
I know you girls move right around. That's
no way. I don't even know if that car.
No. You know, I don't want to talk about that all the time. People say that I have a fixation about my penis, and that's not good.
Liza, you should get a website with all the penis.
You have a website?
Oh, no, she's like a fan of an uglypenis.com website.
Really?
She sent me these photos. It's really gross. And now we have a tiny little penis.
Yeah, Susie liked it more than me. She's like, hey, what's that?
I wake up at 7 and I'm checking my email, and the first thing I see as I wake up is a guy laying in the bed completely.
No, he was on a rug, I think.
I think he was just laying down, some fat carrots and bologna guy with a pink little tiny thing coming up.
No, he was white.
It looked like a carrot.
And then his penis was pink.
Yeah.
It looked like a carrot.
No, it was way smaller than that.
It was like that. It was like a Vienna sausage.
It's a Vienna sausage.
It was disgusting.
That would be.
Yeah, thank you.
Well, I thought you needed a new boyfriend. Yeah.
Well, Willard, I really had a nice time at your party, and I've met a lot of interesting people.
Dennis, thanks so much for coming. You were the life of the party. In fact, the reason why I had it in the first place.
Thank you, Willard.
See you the next one.
Okay. Thank you.